Graduates, today we celebrate you and your accomplishments. You are college graduates now. You should be proud of yourselves. We at CGCC are very proud of you. I hope you've been wearing your regalia, taking lots of pictures and posting them all over social media. Show off. You've certainly earned the right. So, just when you thought that you were done with schoolwork and assignments, I'm going to ask you to do two very important things. The first is be a change agent, and the second, continue learning. Unlike most assignments you've received during your academic career, these are things that, in order for them to be truly meaningful, have no due date. To really make a difference in your life and that of others, these things need to become part of who you are as a person. For those of you ready to step into the workforce, the country will need you to help not just rebuild, but potentially recreate society. We have been learning many lessons throughout this pandemic, not the least of which has been the highlighting of already existing inequities. Hate speech is no longer something shared behind closed doors or in hushed voices. More than ever now, it's shouted in public arenas and posted prolifically on social media. And many of us may be overcome with shame and anger following the deaths of unarmed people by law enforcement. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. said, "Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that." Violence is not the answer. Education, empathy, compassion all have the potential to overcome hate. It is up to you, as the next generation of leaders, to ensure that we don't just return to normal, but that instead we aspire to be better than normal. There needs to be a new normal. This is where my first request, being a change agent, comes in. I encourage you to be part of the solution and to get involved in making this a place where you can be proud to live and where those you care about and the generations that follow will feel safe and feel like they belong. A place where everyone is treated with dignity and respect. A place where being a human being is far more important than membership in any racial, ethnic, religious, or gender group. It may seem like an insurmountable task, but if we all play a role, we can make it happen. As to the second request, for those of you looking to go to a four-year institution to continue your education, don't be discouraged if you can't get away just yet. The most important thing right now is that you keep yourself safe. So if at all possible, continue your studies online until it is safe for you to go. Education is at your fingertips, regardless of where you are. So make the decision that is best for you and your family at this time. The world outside of your hometown will be waiting for you when the time is right for you to venture off. What you can't do is allow this bump in the road to deter your goals. Stay the course and remain focused on the finish line. You will get there. Life will likely continue to place some obstacles in front of you, and you will deal with them and overcome them. Whatever comes your way, you can tackle it. You're Chinooks, and as you know, salmon are experts at swimming upstream. Your future is bright despite what you may be feeling or experiencing at the moment. Keep your eye on the prize, whatever you have determined that to be for you. Congratulations, Chinooks. We at CGCC wish you the very best with whatever your next step might be in this adventure we call life. Stay safe and take care of yourselves and each other.
Hi, my name is Cayenne Ingram. I was awarded with the Outstanding GED Graduate. I feel so grateful for this acknowledgement. However, I did not achieve it alone. I have an amazing family that had so much faith in me. Their faith made me see I could succeed. In addition to family, I had tremendous support from the students in the GED program. They pushed me to keep going and gave me so much encouragement. I also had incredible teachers like Andy. I was not in his class for long, but in that short time, I learned so much, and his attitude for learning made me excited to learn. Along with Kristen Booth, who got me reading again, which made the GED test so much easier. Also, my math teacher, Mrs. H, she was so patient with me, and her patience made it to where I never felt overwhelmed and gave me an environment I could learn in. Last but not least, Matt. I think I learned the most from him. He showed me there are different ways to figure out math, which made it easier for me to find out what worked for me. He also came in extra days to teach me algebra. The dedication from all the teachers is so inspiring. All they want is for the students to succeed. I had an amazing experience in the GED program. I'm so grateful for everyone who helped me through. Thank you, GED department, family, and friends. I couldn't have done it without you.
Graduating class of 2020, congratulations. Can you believe we made it? I feel like those words are the opening lines for many graduation speeches like this, but for the class of 2020, they really are so appropriate. Spring term was topsy-turvy, with faculty and students adjusting to all online or Zoom classes. Staff changed their schedules to accommodate a closed campus and working from home, with advisors meeting students via Zoom or phone. While our world has not become a completely socially distant society, it feels that way sometimes, and nowhere more so than in our schools. Extroverted friends tell me they desperately miss interacting with fellow students, while as an introvert, I realize that even I miss my time with others. What I wouldn't have given last term for just one in-person class, a chance to interact with classmates and faculty. I miss standing outside student services while nursing students stream down the stairs, stopping to visit ASG or PTK tables on their way out the door. While the wearing of masks and maintaining a 6-foot distance from others has become the new normal, CGCC students have risen to the occasion and proven that even separated by this pandemic, we really are stronger together. I think we've all mastered Zoom, but I think more than that, this pandemic has given us the opportunity to really learn how to collaborate using technology, allowing us to communicate even if we can't do it in person. An inevitable outcome of the socially distanced closed campus policy that had to be instituted for spring term would be a decline in class participation or students dropping classes because of the new online-only format. But look at us. We are proof that the world can mess with us, but we will persevere. We have learned to be flexible, accepting the adjusted format of our classes. We have learned to be adaptable, appreciating the changing environment in higher education, which allows more students to receive a college degree than ever before. Sure, someone like myself is probably more socially awkward now, but I believe one good thing has come out of our term with a socially distanced college experience. As a non-traditional student, going back to school and earning my degree was only made possible by colleges offering online courses, but not every class was available online for all degrees. Since the staff and faculty at CGCC have all had to learn the art of online courses, maybe this will open up the ability for every degree to be offered both online and in person, allowing distance learners and non-traditional students like myself the chance to earn their degree from home. That is part of the strength I have seen from this new world we live in. Online classes can and will be challenging for some students and even faculty, but we have proven they are possible. My experience with the editing and publishing class during spring term is a great example of a traditional in-person course that could have suffered from becoming an online class. It is usually held in person with students collaborating and working through the editing process together in class and weekly labs. Changing to an online format was a challenge, both for our instructor and the students. However, the willingness of both parties to adjust was absolutely amazing. Nothing was going to prevent any of us from completing this class, and because we were all passionate about the end result, we pushed through. Never once did students or instructor waver in their determination or dedication. Math instructors rose to the challenge and put together classes using the Zoom or online format, then taught those classes while learning how to use Moodle at the same time. Not an easy feat. From the nursing program to a general studies degree, the challenge was accepted and adjustments were made. These last 2 years at CGCC have given me so much more than a degree. They have become an opportunity to do something I never thought possible. With the help of an advisor who never pressured or bullied me, I have stepped way out of my comfort zone to acquire leadership skills and work on public speaking. I put so many limits on myself in the past, but these last 2 years have shattered those and any future limits. I mean, why limit ourselves? I think that same thing can be said of all of us. Look what we've already done, so now what more can we do? Let's take that resilient spirit we've shown here and apply it to what faces us every day at home or the workplace. Speakers always tell us the sky's the limit. Well, guess what? They're right. So to the world and life, I say, challenge accepted.